Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and Apple released iOS 15.4 last week, and we've all been using it for about a week or so. And I've been using it full time on my 13 Pro Max, but if you're a developer or public beta tester and were using iOS 15.4 RC, you've actually been using it for about 2 weeks. So I wanted to talk about what the overall experience is like, not just my experience, but your experience based off the YouTube community poll, where there's thousands of votes, hundreds and hundreds of comments, where I've compiled all of that information to give you the best understanding of battery life, not only on the latest devices, but older devices too. So we'll talk about that, as well as what the overall experience is like, any remaining bugs, and if you can install it on your device if you haven't already. But first, I wanted to talk about a few new features that I didn't mention in the initial What's New video. There were over 20 minutes of just new features and changes alone, and there's even a few more. So let's take a look at those first. Now, the first change has to do with visual lookup. This is a feature we've had in the United States for a while, but it's now available in Canada, also places such as the UK, Singapore, Germany, and a few other places it's showing up as well. So you may or may not have this, but what it does is allows you to maybe take a picture of a tree or a flower or a landmark, and it will give you more information about that. That's something that you can typically see. Let me show you what it looks like. You can see here's a photo I took of the World Trade Center and the Oculus here. And down at the bottom where you have the eye, you actually have a little star on it. Tap on that and it will give you more information about it. So it will tell you exactly where it is, give you more information about the landmark and more. So you have a lot of information here. If you take a photo, it says One World Trade Center and then more information about that. So hopefully that's showing up in your country. And if it's outside of those countries I mentioned, let me know in the comments below if you're seeing it as well. There's also an update in shortcuts. So maybe you're adding something to do with battery. They've updated the icons here. And you'll see it says get battery level and set low power mode. Now those are different colors and they look a little different. Just a small change to the icons, but it is an update. Also in Safari, there's an update that I didn't mention. And if you're using experimental features and you go into settings, then you go to Safari. Under Safari, go all the way to the bottom, go to advanced. Under advanced, experimental features, go all the way to the bottom. Maybe you changed all of these things. If you go all the way to the bottom, you now have reset all to defaults. I mentioned this in some of the earlier beta videos, but I never mentioned it in the What's New video. So those three things are what's new in this update that I didn't mention in the initial update video. And like I said, right now, iOS 15.4 RC and the public release are the same thing. So we have a ton of data of what it's like as far as the overall experience. But one thing I did, I thought that would be a little bit fun, is ask you on Twitter what you thought was the best iPhone color. Now that Apple has some new green colors, this is Sierra Blue. But if we go to Twitter, I wanted to show you that poll as well. Now on Twitter, I know not everyone follows me there, so I wanted to share this. But as far as your favorite iPhone color, 24% of you said that you liked green or alpine green, 49% of you said blue or Sierra blue, 9% said red, and 18% said other, such as gold, space gray, or silver. And that's out of 3,492 votes. So a ton of people are actually talking about that. So that's great to hear what your opinion is. I know a lot of people really like blue. I actually really like the green color, the new alpine green, as well as Pacific blue. I think those are some of my favorites, but I typically lean towards graphite unless I'm doing a video about it and need to show a new color. Now, the overall experience is quite stable for most people. However, there are some odd things some people actually experience, such as maybe the phone really slowing down. Now, this is pretty few and far between. I haven't experienced it, but typically when you reboot the phone, it resolves that issue. So most people are not seeing that, and most people say that it performs better than any version of iOS 15. So that's a great thing. Also, in settings, the storage bug is resolved in this update. So if we go into general and then we go to iPhone storage, I won't be mentioning that anymore since it's resolved unless it's changed and it's not resolved in maybe future updates. Now, it taking a while to load is not the problem. As long as it loads within, say, 30 seconds, it's not an issue. And then these things will fill in with the different data and more. Down at the bottom, you'll see it's taking a bit for system data to show up. That's normal. As long as it shows up, it's actually working. And as long as these numbers are correct, it's working. So the storage bug was a problem where it wouldn't either load at all or the numbers were actually really incorrect. Now, many have messaged me and said that system data is just taking up way too much data in this update. And so I wanted to mention that a little bit because system data changes. So maybe you install an iOS update. It's 5 gigabytes. It doesn't take up an additional 5 gigabytes to what your iPhone is already using, but instead it installs the update or downloads it, unzips it or uncompresses it, then installs the update, does all the background processes, then removes what it doesn't need anymore. So you'll see here, iOS is taking up 9.18 gigabytes and then 29 kilobytes for system data. It will change over time and reduce your storage. So as long as you don't need that storage, you'll see I have quite a bit free. If I go to the top, I have 109 gigabytes used out of 256. So I have quite a bit left. So don't worry about that storage. It's not a big deal. It will actually resolve itself, and that will fix itself on its own. Now, also those of you that have mentioned pink or purple displays, that seems to be resolved in this update. I haven't heard a single person mention it other than in some of the earlier betas. It seems to be resolved despite Apple not mentioning it. Now, performance on older devices, even the iPhone 6S and 6S Plus, again, many people are saying that it's performing quite well. So it's good on all of them with the exception of that stutter and slowdown I mentioned, and a reboot seems to fix that. Now, the big question a lot of you seem to have is, what is battery life? You're concerned about upgrading because of battery life. And so let me share my battery life, then I'll share a couple others' battery life, and then I'll talk about what hundreds of you had to say. So the first thing is, if we go into settings, we'll go back here, we'll go down to battery, battery health. On my phone is 100%. This has been used every day, put on the charger every single night, and it's my main phone. If we go to the last 10 days, every one of these last 10 days was on iOS 15.4, and so yesterday was not as good, but 3 hours and 56 minutes of screen on time, 6 hours and 46 minutes of screen off time, and I used about 60% of the battery, 60 to 65%. Today, 50% of the battery, 3 hours and 26 minutes. Now, this isn't great for most people on a 13 Pro Max. However, I have some odd issues here and there using some of the background activity, such as music, because that music bug is still there. So most people say that this is much, much better. I can get through a day without a problem. Usually you can get 10 to 14 hours of screen on time with this, but let me share a couple others with you. Now, Abhishek sent in his battery life on an 11 Pro Max, and as you send in your battery life, I'll be sure to maybe pick randomly if there's a bunch of them, or just use those in example videos every weekend for follow-ups. But he has an 11 Pro Max, and he had 4 hours and 49 minutes of screen on time, 40 minutes of screen off time, and used about 55% of his battery. The day before that, 5 hours and 26 minutes. Now, Lewis sent in his battery life on Telegram. I have a Telegram channel he did, as well as a Discord channel. But Lewis sent this in. This is on a 13 Pro Max. 100% usage, he got 14 hours and 30 minutes and 11 minutes of screen off time. On the other day, he sent in 15 hours and 56 minutes. And so you can see he just started charging it. So there is a charge in between there. It can make a difference, but typically it's getting most people through the day. And according to what you had to say on the YouTube community poll, most people say battery life is better than 15.3.1 or earlier versions. By a lot, 77% of you have said that battery was better than before, 23% of you say that it's worse. That's after using over 200 data points from different people saying it was better, the same, or worse. So if it was the same or better, 77%. So that's pretty good, and that's better than out of any other update we've had in a long time. Now, stability is good. I haven't had any crashes, but I have had some issues with cellular connectivity. Lately, switching again between 5G and 5G UC, this could be specific to T-Mobile since I see a few other people mention this, but data will drop temporarily. So if it's switching between 4G LTE and then over to 5G, sometimes data will just drop, then it will come right back. So there's some little blip there sometimes that happens. Now, that doesn't happen to everyone, but it does happen to me on the 13 Pro Max. Now, as far as Wi-Fi, not a single person mentioned that there was a problem with it, and one person mentioned Bluetooth, but was reporting that it was better with their headphones. So this is great news, and typically I do this test where I use my AirPods and just kind of open them up and see what happens. So let's try that here. I'll grab my AirPods, AirPods 3. Let's open them up. Oh, one just fell out on the table. Let's see what happens. It still has not come up on my phone. Let's see, it popped up on my iPad, and there it's on my phone. For me, it connects fine, but sometimes it does seem a little bit delayed. But I've had no problems with it cutting out or anything like that. Like I said, that music bug is still there. Streaming music still seems to be a problem for me. So that is a problem where it uses additional power and then battery life. And some people do mention that the phone is getting a little bit warmer, but typically that's not an issue. Apple manages that very aggressively on the phone, but if it's getting to the point where it's dimming the display, well, then that can be an issue. Also, CarPlay continues to have issues, but less people mentioned a problem this time around. So if it's disconnecting from CarPlay, it seems to be better, and I would love to hear from you in the comments below about that. Now, I did want to share with you the Geekbench scores, and then we'll talk about if you should update or not. I just ran the benchmark a couple times on the 13 Pro Max, and this shows that the single core is great, 1,718, and then multi-core is a little bit lower than when I ran it with the RC when it was first installed, so 4,679. Before, it was about 4,800. So it can vary a lot. If I ran this a little bit later, maybe it was done processing in the background, maybe I bring the screen brightness down, it could improve. As far as the iPhone X and iPhone 12 Pro I have here, you can see both of them here. So I ran both of them. You'll see there's a screen protector on the right phone, so it looks a little bit different, but that gives you an idea of what it looks like as far as benchmarks go, and hopefully yours are within 100 or 200 or so. That typically is within range. As long as you're there, you shouldn't have any issues. Now, if you're still wondering if you should install iOS 15.4 and you haven't yet, I would highly recommend that you do based off of security alone. If you go to Apple's security website, you can see all of the updates here where there's tons of different updates to security. So everything from core media to cellular to FaceTime to kernel and so on. You can see there's pages and pages of updates, notes and music and Bluetooth. So I would highly recommend it for that, but you're also gaining over 50 changes and updates, as well as performance that seems to be better than any other version of 15. So iOS 15 was a bit buggy to begin with. This seems to be a much more stable version where battery really improves over time. So if you're not seeing that improvement yet, give it a few days if you just installed it, and then it should improve. Usually it will take a few days and then you gain the benefits of it. Then we'll move on to the next version. So I would expect iOS 15.5 beta 1 probably early next week. Typically with all the releases that Apple pushed out with the new iPad and iPhone SE and then these iOS updates, they usually wait until the following week and then we'll move into 15.5. Then later on, we'll get to WWDC 2022, where we'll see iOS 16. So iOS 16, iPadOS 16, watchOS 9, macOS 13, and then of course TV and HomePodOS 16 as well. Then we'll see all of the major feature changes and more. We'll see those in June, then typically we'll have that released in September. Now we can expect those updates for, or those invites rather, for WWDC 2022 typically at the end of the month. So last year they pushed it out on the 30th. We can expect it around that time frame where we'll have WWDC. Now the question right now is whether or not that will be a virtual event or be in person. Typically in the past couple of years it's been virtual. Maybe they'll do one more that's virtual since Google's doing that again with Google I/O, or maybe they'll be the first in-person event in a long time, or they'll just wait for a while and do that in September. But either way, we should get those invites within another week or so and know more about that. Now let's go ahead and take a look at some of the comments from the community poll, and about 10 or so of them, and see what you had to say. So the first one is from Kevin Taylor. It says, since iOS 15, I've been having horrible standby time on my iPad Pro 2018 and just canceled my Apple Music and deleted the app. And now the standby time is only dropping about 2% overnight now instead of almost 40 to 50%. So I think it was that problem, that music bug you've been posting about. Other than that, 15.4 is amazing and great battery life across all my devices. And that's definitely an issue. If you've got Apple Music on your device and you're using it in streaming, Apple mentioned that in earlier betas where it was a problem, and they haven't yet at least mentioned that they've fixed it. So hopefully they have, but when you're streaming and you didn't download that music, it's definitely different. Ahmed said, everything's great. One issue is cellular, 5G and LTE disconnects for 4 seconds. And similar to what I was experiencing, it seems when it switches, sometimes it just drops the internet altogether. In fact, while I was recording this video, I had that issue on this device. So it switched from 5G to LTE and just dropped. So I'm not sure what that is. Typically I have pretty good signal. Right now I have 2 bars of LTE, which is odd. Usually it's a little better, but that's what we're at right now. Amit Verma said, the main thing I was waiting for in this update was Face ID with a mask, but I'm disappointed. It works, but only 4 out of 10 times. Now, I've seen some responses to these comments or this comment, and typically I agree with them on this. So generally you want to add your face again and see if that helps. And if you wear glasses, make sure to add that as well. So Face ID with a mask seems to work fine, at least for me, about 9 out of 10 times, if not 10 out of 10. So maybe try adding that. And it could be something to do with maybe where the mask is placed. So if the mask is above maybe your cheekbones, that could probably make a difference. But it's hard to say, as everyone's face is a little different. Barak Yildiz says, everything is fine. I'm so happy using my iPhone 7. The battery is improved. Even battery health is 83%. Interface is very smooth. iPhone 7 users can update their phones with contentment. So this is great news on older phones. Like I said earlier, with the battery overall, it seems to be great on all devices. Tanashi Simbanda, hopefully I'm saying that properly, music volume gets stuck on low after a notification. Have to press volume up for it to go back to normal again. And so I haven't seen this myself, but a couple people mentioned this, so I thought I'd mention this comment. Lara Body says, update seems fine overall, but my iOS and system data has drastically increased, reducing my overall storage by 3 GB. I would give that a few days. Typically that will improve and then just be back to normal. So usually after it finishes processing or indexing in the background, it no longer needs those update files and sort of offloads them and gets rid of them. Austin Holland said, so far the only issue I have on my iPhone 11 Pro is the battery isn't lasting as long. I've had the 15.4 update since the release day. So usually I would say give it a few days, but it's been a few days. So hopefully it improves, but I would go into your battery, see if there's anything abnormal. Otherwise, maybe reboot and see if that resolves the issue. Maybe do a hard reboot where you press volume up, volume down, press and hold your power sleep wake button until it reboots. Hopefully that resolves it, as it seems to resolve a lot of the other small odd issues I mentioned earlier. MegaLO86 says, on my iPhone SE 2020, the battery life has improved with the most noticeable difference in standby as the percentage barely drops compared to before. So this is great news. Overnight, it's not dropping. That's what's happening on my iPad as well. It seems to be greatly improved when it's actually turned off, but I'm just still having some odd issues with the iPad. Blaz Novak says, battery is very bad. It's just draining like crazy. Updated yesterday on the 13 Pro Max. And if you updated yesterday, like I said, make sure you give it a couple days and see if it changes. Hopefully it will actually fix that over a couple days. The Tech Librarian says, iPhone 13 Pro Max on 15.4 has introduced some new bugs. I've had some dropped calls and freezing that wasn't present until updating. So like I said, maybe a hard reboot fixes that problem. Typically it seems to for most people. I've had a couple people mention that to me and it did resolve their issues. So a few odd bugs here and there, but for the most part, it seems to be very stable. Gaurav Tandon says, I'm on iOS 15.4 on 13 Pro, and it's the most awesome and stable update to date. Absolutely love this update. ProMotion feels much better and more fluid. The Face ID with a mask works really well. Great videos, Aaron. Thank you. And we'll take a look at one more. Tomato Blast says, everything is buttery smooth on my iPhone 11, but the battery life is going down the drains. I usually got around 7 hours of screen on time on the previous versions, and now I'm barely making it to 5:30. I don't know if the problem of my battery or it's something else. If anyone has a solution, please let me know. And so with that, I would say, like I said, give it a couple days, see if it improves, but it seems to be really hit or miss, as over 75% of people are saying it's better. So if you look at most of the comments, it seems to improve, but it does take a few days, sometimes more for others. I would say on an older phone, it could process a little bit longer since it's a little slower processor. So there's definitely factors to consider there. And so that's everything with iOS 15.4. I think it's definitely the best update since iOS 15 as far as stability, at least what I'm hearing from you over the past couple of weeks. So hopefully it continues this way and we see more and more stability with iOS 16 and more. Now, if there's any additional features or anything else you'd like to see in videos like this, whether it be outside or different locations, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.